Hey, what's up YouTube? I am back with another video and today we are talking about how to best shoot photos with your new GoPro Hero 8 Black. Before we start with the video though, if this video is helpful, give it a thumbs up, show it some engagement because it helps me and helps the channel grow. And with that, let's jump right into the video. So as you guys know, swiping left and right on the display allows you to switch between the time-lapse mode, the video mode, and the photo mode. Today we are having a look at our photo settings, so let's stay here with the photo mode. Now as you can see, the new GoPro Hero 8 Black has four shortcuts on the display that allows for easy access for frequently used functions of this camera. On the upper left we have the button for the timer, where you can choose a shutter delay of either 0 seconds, 3 seconds or 10 seconds. We don't need this at this point, so we turn this off again. On the lower left, we have the button for the different fields of view. Here you can choose between wide, which is the standard field of view for this camera, which is fairly wide and introduces a fisheye effect or barrel distortion, which not everyone likes. If you don't, then you can choose linear. Here the GoPro applies software correction for the barrel distortion. It's a bit more zoomed in, but definitely it's a more natural look. A lot of people may choose this. Otherwise, you can also choose narrow, which is a bit more zoomed in, not necessarily something that I would use on an everyday basis, but if that's your standard or preferred field of view, you can choose it here. At this point though, we leave it at wide. On the upper right, we can choose the output, hence how the GoPro is processing and exporting our image. Standard, here the GoPro applies the standard settings and export as a JPEG file. With HDR, that stands for High Dynamic Range, the GoPro shoots several different images, exposing for the darker and the lighter parts of your frame and then combines it in one single JPEG file. And then with Super Photo, the GoPro applies automatic advanced image processing to give you the best possible results. It takes a little longer to process your image, but if you don't want to adjust your settings for your current lighting conditions, Super Photo will probably give you the best result. And then finally, you have the option to export your image as a RAW file. Now with all the other options, where the GoPro is creating a JPEG for you, it automatically processes the image based on the settings that you provided, and all the image information that isn't needed anymore, the GoPro deletes. With RAW, however, the GoPro saves an only minimally corrected sensor readout, preserving all the image information. Now, first of all, that gives you most flexibility because you can process the image to your liking yourself using a program like, for instance, Adobe Lightroom or Skylum Lumina. On the other hand, however, the image files are obviously larger because, again, the GoPro is preserving all the image information, and since you have to process the image manually yourself, it's an extra step in your workflow and therefore it takes longer, it takes more time. Now I switch back to standard for the time being, but we talk about the output options again later. So let's have a look at the final shortcut on the lower right, and here the GoPro gives you the option to zoom. What it does is pretty self-explanatory. I barely use it, so let's move on and let's have a look at the different profiles. Now with the GoPro Hero 8 Black, GoPro has introduced a new feature, which is profiles for your photo and video settings, which is absolutely fantastic. Because now, if you want to adjust to your current shooting scenario, you don't have to adjust a bunch of different settings. You can just create profiles and switch between them very quickly and very conveniently. Now, as you can see, there are a bunch of different predefined profiles already. You can adjust them, you can add new ones. Today, we're having a look at the photo profile, which is the standard profile for shooting photos, the one that you would be using most of the time. So now that we've covered the basic settings and have them out of the way, let's talk about my lazy man settings. The settings that I can recommend if you want the GoPro to take over and automatically create the images for you. Now you still want to choose the lens, your preferred field of view. I usually stick with linear because I prefer a more natural look, but when it comes to photos, I really don't mind that slight barrel distortion with wide, so I usually pick either of the two, just go with what you like the most. Now when it comes to the output, however, and you don't feel comfortable with setting up the GoPro every time for your shooting or lighting scenario, and you want to fly your GoPro in autopilot mode, I can only recommend to go with Super Photo. It won't give you the exact results that you're after all the time, but it definitely should make you happy with the photo that the GoPro provides. But now, since the GoPro in Super Photo is essentially in auto mode, it won't give you access to all the advanced settings under ProTune. So most of them are not available, but there are some still that you can adjust. Let's talk about them real quick. Now let's have a look at the white balance. And here you can select the color tone of your photo. And the GoPro does a fairly good job with choosing the white balance automatically. But if you want to have a little bit more control over the final look of your image, you can choose the white balance manually. You can either warm the image up if you're in a more cooler lighting environment, like for instance when it's overcast, or you can cool the image down if you're in a rather warm lighting scenario, like for instance during sunsets or sunrises. There's also the option to pick native, which again is only minimally corrected, so you can pick the white balance in post. But in my opinion, when you already chose Super Photo, having that option native really defeats the purpose. So go and pick your white balance yourself, or stick to auto and have the GoPro adjust the white balance automatically. The other setting that we can adjust under Super Photo is sharpness, which essentially is the level of details the GoPro is capturing in your photos. By default, it's set to high. In my opinion, that looks way too sharp. It looks almost unnatural. You can either set this to medium or low. Low would require to adjust sharpening again in post. In my opinion, we want to avoid this since we're under Super Photo already. So go with medium and you should be fine. So these are my lazy man settings when I don't want to do anything in post-production. Just transfer the files of the GoPro to my smartphone and then share the images on social media or with family and friends. But now, as a second step, let's also look at how to set up the GoPro if you want to get the most flexibility and then process the photos with your photo editing tool, like for instance Lightroom or Lumina. And since we are doing the processing ourselves, we want to capture all the image information because we may need it in post-processing, and therefore for output, we choose RAW. Because here, as I said earlier, the GoPro saves an only minimally processed sensor readout as a RAW file, which is here our GPR file, alongside a JPEG file. So we have a RAW file that we can process in our post-processing software, and we have a JPEG file that we can use as, let's say, a preview file, or again, something that can be quickly and easily shared with family and friends and on social media. So now, since we are not flying in auto mode anymore, when we are looking at ProTune, which are the advanced settings for the GoPro, they're all available to us. So let's have a quick look what we can do with them. Shutter, which essentially is the shutter speed that I usually keep at auto and let the GoPro decide what shutter speed to choose for the current lighting scenario. That also gives me a little bit of flexibility because it allows the GoPro to slightly adjust the exposure automatically. So not everything that I set here needs to be 100%. And then we have exposure value compensation, where you can slightly adjust the exposure of your photo, especially helpful when you're in harsh or bright lighting conditions, because here the GoPro tends to clip the highlights. So what I do is set the exposure value compensation to -5 in order to preserve some of the information in the brights or in the highlights of your photo. The white balance settings should not affect your RAW file because we'll choose the white balance in post-processing with our image editing software. So here, if you want to adjust the white balance for your JPEG file, feel free to do so. Otherwise, just keep it at auto. So let's have a look at the ISO settings. An ISO essentially determines the sensitivity of your sensor to light. The higher the ISO, the more sensitive the sensor, which means it captures more information in low light conditions. However, the higher the ISO, also more noise is being added to the image. So setting the ISO is always a balancing act between the low light capabilities of your camera and how much noise you're willing to accept in your photo. And even though image noise can be easily edited out with photos in post-processing, I prefer a cleaner to a brighter image, so I keep the minimum ISO at 100, but I lower the maximum ISO to 1600.
So, as I said earlier, when it comes to sharpness, high is way too high, medium is great if you don't want to do anything in post-processing, but since here we are shooting in RAW and we want to add sharpening as needed with our image editing software, I can only recommend to go with low, because that gives you the flexibility to add sharpness to your image, to your liking, and as needed. Now finally, let's have a look at the color profiles, and here you have two profiles to choose from. First of all, GoPro, which gives you an already color processed image with punchy contrast and vivid colors, which is great if you don't want to do anything in post-production. But if you want to do some editing in post-production, I can only recommend to go with Flat. Flat is a more neutral color profile which has a wider curve, which means it preserves more information in the highlights and the shadows of your photo, but it will be only affecting the JPEG file. And since we have already the RAW file to play with in our editing software, and I don't think you want to also meddle with the JPEG file, just switch it back to GoPro. So that gives you a JPEG file that doesn't need any work anymore, so we can focus with our editing on our RAW file, because that again gives us more flexibility in post-production. And essentially, these are my settings if you want to get the best photos possible out of your GoPro and don't shy away of do a little bit of extra work with editing the photo with your image editing software, again, Lightroom or Lumina. So before I let you guys go and my voice is gone, I just wanted to give you some examples on what the output looks like. Now, first of all, we look at the standard JPEG, then the HDR output, then the super photo, and then the RAW file. And obviously the RAW edits are a little bit over the top, but I just wanted to show you guys what's possible with the GoPro. One thing notable is that the HDR output indoors, especially in low light, is really struggling. Outdoors it works great, but indoors HDR is definitely not something I would be using. But as you guys can see, the super photo output usually performs very, very well. Now, if you guys want to know how to edit the RAW files, there's a link in the upper right corner to an introduction to Lumina. You'll also find a discount code where you can save some money, and also have a look in the description below. There's a link to my selfie account where you can download my Lightroom presets. And just in case you want to get more information about how to edit your GoPro RAW files in Lightroom, there's an upcoming video that I'm working on at the moment. So please subscribe to my channel so you don't miss out.
So this is it, my friends. This is how to best shoot photos with your new GoPro Hero 8 Black, and I hope this video was helpful. If it was, give it a thumbs up because it helps me and helps the channel grow. Anything that I haven't addressed in today's video, just leave a comment down below and I'll get back to you. And most importantly, if you want to see more about this type of content, subscribe to my channel and hit that bell icon so you get notified when I'm uploading new videos. And with that, as always, I catch you guys in my next video.